their best lap time is a 1:28.2.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Lee, Russell, and Esteban Ocon. Goodbye for now then, but we are really just getting started. Make sure you join us again for Lights Out tomorrow. Welcome along then to Portimão, one of the busiest towns in the Algarve and a breathtaking destination that brings tourists from all around the world to the shores of southern Portugal. Today, it's the backdrop for the latest round of the Formula One World Championship. And with a circuit this wide, we could be in for a lot of exciting wheel-to-wheel action today. So Portimão features 15 turns over the course of its 2.9-mile length. 9 are right-handers, while 6 are to the left. This is a track with a lot of uphill action, which only accentuates the importance of getting those exits right, especially at Turn 4, where a good line can present opportunities to pass on the way into Turn 5. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Lee lines up on pole position, just ahead of George Russell, who starts this event from P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ocon, Verstappen, Charles Leclerc, and Liam Lawson. Gasly, Sainz, Ricciardo, and Lando Norris. Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher, Kevin Magnussen, Fittipaldi, Fernando Alonso, Albon, Robert Schwartzman, and Sergio Perez. Oscar Piastri. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Latifi. Stroll. And Guan Yu Zhou. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. Natalie Pinkham. A lot of talented drivers out on the track today, but what will stand out for you?
My focus is 100% on the front of the grid. Like you said, we're seeing a lot of strong competition across those positions, so it'll be so interesting to see the fight for that front spot. Personally speaking, I'm hoping for plenty of overtakes.
The formation lap gets underway and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure their car is ready for the battle once the lights go out. So as all the cars take their positions on the grid, the teams will be hoping their strategies pay off for them in today's race. But the question I'm asking is which teams have got it right and which teams have got it horribly wrong.
car ahead and in the DRS zone.
who are out in the lane and ready to perform their magic on the car. They're going to be aiming to achieve the fastest pit stop time possible.
Thank you. by 23.3 seconds. On the lap time was over 1 minute, 18.9.
And so the celebrations begin, and well-earned they are indeed. It may have looked simple at times, but as any racing driver will tell you, competing at this level, at the very top, is anything but simple. There's no catching them now then. We have a new World Drivers Champion. Not just victory today then, but the championship as well. What a spectacular season they've had, and congratulations to the whole team. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out of the track was. Speed. It sounds like an awfully reductive statement, but fast cars win races. And we saw that today with our winner.
Here comes your top three, making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One. Let's focus on driver of the day, Natalie Pinkham. Come on, who do you pick?
Well, there was a lot of incredible driving out there today, but if I had to pick someone, it's got to be Sergio Perez. Fantastic driving.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.